Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you a nice photo add-on that will improve the version overview in control panel. So by default, Volto comes with this version overview control panel where you have the front end version, the Volto version, some backend information, and the front end add-ons. But sometimes you want here to see some more information about when the front end or the back end was updated. Also, you want some back end information, like I don't know, what version of Plon scales do you have on the back end? Or so let's see. First, this add-on requires a backend add-on called EAAPI control panel. So I will start. I will use Docker to start my backend, and via the environment variable add-ons, I will add the EAAPI control panel add-on on the backend. You see that it will install the EAAPI control panel on the backend, and then it will end up in a bash terminal. As I said here, the command to be bash and not to start the SOAP server. Now if I go and run whiskey minus v etc SOAP ini config file, I will have a Plon backend up and running in a few seconds. Have the ZOP up and running. I will create the Plon site. If the default language, then the time zone. And then I can go to control panel on the classic UI and install the EA control panel add-on. This add-on will add some entries in the configuration registry, where we will store this front end back end versions when it was updated and so on. So if I look for the records added by this add-on, you'll see it will add EA versions back end, date all version. Now on the front end, I added the EACMS Volto control panel in the add-ons section and in dependencies. And now if I start prod to speed it up a little bit, I can see, I set up in the version overview, I already have the front end version, and the back end have more information. Like, let's see if I look for plon.scales or also EAAPI control panel is version 1.0. Now, if I want to update this version, so every time when you deploy a new version of the backend, you provide this environment variable same for front end. So it's Razzle front end version, and you can say 2.5 2.3 4 4. And if I go to registry, I can see that registry was automatically updated when the backend started, and also on the front end will start, will update this version. If I go to front end, I will have the front end version 2.3.4, backend 1.2.3. This is the initial version, and now if I update, let's call it 2.3.5, and then on the backend I can say the version is 1.3.0. Now, if I go to registry, I can see that all the informations were updated, except the old version on front end. See, it was updated today at 11:44. Same for the backend, and then it was updated from version 1.2.3 to version 1.3.0. Here the front end was updated from 2.3.4 to 2.3.5, and then you have all the detailed versions here. Now these links by default links to the EA GitHub repository, but in front end you can override this via environment variables. So Razzle front end, let's see, we have this Razzle change of prefix, you can say it's https://example.com, then Razzle suffix change log, and then frontend name. If you want to override also this one, is taken from the packages JSON of the frontend, but if you can override this, because this one is used in when composing the link. So let's say it's my custom frontend, then you can also override the Razzle backend, my custom backend, and then you can say this is version 2.4.0. So the version was updated, the registry was updated to 2.2.4.0. And now if I go to site setup, I refresh, site setup 2.4.0, history will link to example.com, my custom frontend changelog, and the backend will link to example.com, my custom backend changelog. And that's it.